Hi, my name is Michaela Thomas, and today I will be doing a shot-by-shot analysis of Blood and Water. Blood and Water is a South African drama revolving around a high school girl whose sister was kidnapped as a baby as part of a human trafficking network. While the main character, Pulang, never got to know her sister, her absence left an ever-apparent mark on the lives of her entire family. When another year passes since her sister's kidnapping, exhausted from the high emotions that arise after celebrating yet another of her missing sister's birthday without her return, she sneaks off to a party with a friend to relieve some stress, where she will eventually meet a girl she suspects to be her sister, setting her on a long road, where she will set out to solve the big mystery and find some answers to her burning questions.
Oh, no. Please don't. I hate pictures of myself. Yeah. It's actually not bad. You're really good at this.
I have a great subject. Do you know this girl? You remind me of her, like, the shape of your faces and something about your eyes.
What? She's way too pretty.
She's alright.
Yeah, you're right. She's totally hideous.
Yo, everyone, come closer. Fix, make your way up, please. Fix. Ladies and gentlemen, your birthday girl, Fikile Bele.
That's Fikile, the one I was just talking about. It's a birthday, of course, if you didn't know.
Happy 17th birthday, you old hag. I love you. Now let's drink!
Is it Fikile's birthday today or during the week?
It's today.
She shares the same birthday as my sister.
No. That's cool. Where is she?
She's out with some friends.
In this scene, Pulang's new friend, Wade, begins taking playful shots of her. After stumbling across some pictures he also took of Fikile, he begins to highlight the similarities in the physical features of their faces. But Lang, on the other hand, is unable to view herself as being as beautiful as this Mr. Girl. Moments after their brief discussion, Fikile appears on the balcony in the sky, and Pulang not only discovers that the Mr. Girl from the photo is the one who's the center of the celebration, but also realizes that she has the same birthday as her missing sister. In this scene, as the two characters are relatively dark when they are looking at the photo of the unnamed girl, once they begin to show the girl in the photos, her features are very well lit, which may play into the scene by establishing this girl as the larger-than-life center of attention character she turns out to be. Consistent with portraying her in this way, when she appears on the balcony, she has more light on her than the two characters watching from below along with the other partygoers. The light sources consist of glowing cocktail tables that change colors placed under Pulang and Wade as they chat and look at pictures. They also consist of the camera flash that is directed in such a way that highlights Fikile's features in the picture, colorful lights on the balcony placed under Fikile standing and her friends who eventually come and join her, and strobe lights that are placed all around the house and party. Camera and lenses are used to communicate the pivotal beat when the scene shifts focus from Pulang and Wade to Fikile, and when Pulang begins to piece together the possibility that this might be her missing sister. When the camera moves to focus on Fikile, it's clear that the decision is made to portray the perspective in which Pulang is seeing Fikile, or at least one of the partygoers, from the bottom. Also, when it shifts from Pulang and Wade to Fikile, the lens seems to change from wide to telephoto because we notice that the background characters begin to become blurry, and it's only the main characters who are clear, which lends to the significance of what's playing out in this scene.